Thank you. So hello, everybody, and thanks for being here. We are the last presentation. So my name is Max. This is my friend Six. And we want to present you a small feature or bug we found in all Windows version. So let's go.
So we are working here in Luxembourg as IT security enthusiasts and penetration testers. Actually, most often we do pen tests and red teaming, hacking stuff, and so on. So how we get to this issue which we are presenting is quite simple, because we got the suspicion of some people. We have a lot of other companies that are working for us, and they send some files which look suspicious. Yeah, we are adult related company. Maybe you heard about Live Jasmine. Yeah, I see the smiles. So basically, we are working with many partners, and we just looked into some zip files.
Yeah, basically we received a lot of archives from interested source, and some friends of us told us it might be hacking stuff. So we just fired up an isolated VM, but we could not find anything. But at the same time, we were looking at Wireshark, and we seen some requests from Windows. So we started to look into that.
So basically, after checking out all the files inside, and if something is suspicious or can be malware, we basically found nothing. Yeah, some images, but these were just totally random images. Everything was correct. There were no binaries inside, just really some media content and text files. Still, we wanted to figure out why the users are saying that something is not cool about that. And we saw that there is a link file inside this zip. We started to monitor the traffic. We fired up Wireshark or T-Shark, and we just saw that some NTLM hashes are going out, or trying to go out at least, to remote addresses. And we were like really feeling strange, because why is this happening? So there is nothing inside, or if it's an APT, we got totally infected and we are basically totally screwed up. Yes, that's the nicer word. So what we found is actually a Windows feature in there, not an APT, but quite a dangerous Windows feature.
Yeah, it's pretty similar to the DropLNK exploit, but it's also simpler. And last time I checked the DropLNK on Windows 10 some days ago, it was not working, and this thing is still working. So to recap, we have almost no user interaction is needed. You just have to drop the file anywhere, the LNK or URL file. And as soon as the folder is open, even in the background, then Windows, all version, will automatically fetch any file URL with your NTLM hash. So how to exploit it?
Yes, the first scenario is basically when SMB signing is disabled. In this case, you don't even need to crack it, and you can basically relay those hashes that you receive. So by just creating this simple URL, which we will show you, it's like three clicks or four maybe, and you type the address where you want to leak the hash, you got it, and you just basically relay it. And of course, this kind of SMB signing is disabled in most places, because the system administrators are lazy, people don't want to configure, you need to mess with signing and so on. How many people have this enabled? Anyone? Okay. One. Oh, cool. Yeah. So that's about it. This is the first scenario. And the second.
Yes, where are the guys with the signing? Okay, so if you are, we are in your company, then we will do something more differently. We will drop the LNK file in all writable folder we can find, and then we run responder, and all the machine fetching this URL will send the hash to us. We can't relay it if it's signed, but we will receive, like we see on the screen, the responder is catching the hash. And then you can use the standard tool, hashcat or john, to crack the hash. And then you will likely get, if your password policy is weak, you will likely get users, other admin, or domain admin.
Yeah, so basically continuing the second scenario, cracking, this is not really complicated or not really long. You also receive NTLMv1 hashes if they are not disabled. And well, most often what we find is that it's not disabled. Also, we contacted Microsoft about this issue and they said, yeah, disable NTLM, use Kerberos and so on. But there was a surprising thing when we tried these fix, which we will tell in the end of the slides. So you can see some results, how fast this is. In one of our pen tests, we basically got like 107 hashes in only a few hours because it is automatically sending the hash. The user do not need to do anything because some caches or cache service, whatever is running in Windows. So we just put it in some share and we received 27 hashes, which were cracked successfully and the other ones not. But luckily there were like, administrator hashes, so that was quite of end of the game after this.
Yeah, so a quick reminder, the NTLM is not push the hashable, so you cannot pass the hash, you need to crack it or relay it. So how would you use the crack password? It's quite simple. You use the feature, RDP, VPN, or the webmail to get the guy's email. You can use the standard SMB shell or Metasploit, PSExec, and company. And we want to show you more example. We could use the RPC client using the remote registry if you want to avoid some IDS or fly off the radar. And we could find also a cool trick, which is WinACCM. A lot of companies are running it. This thing is running an agent on Windows computer. So it's basically a rat, and you can use the small binary to manage this agent using this credential.
Yeah, the third scenario, which is actually the most dangerous one, is happening when you do not have the port 445 disabled to the internet. Well, it happens also quite often that it's open. Some routers we saw, like the what was Freezebox, yeah, the Freezebox, for example, is by default blocking it, but it's totally random where it's blocked, where it's not blocked. So basically, you just send the LNK file from whatever email server, whatever place you can send from to the user. The user do not even need to basically open this link file or click on it. It's enough if he just download it to his computer and it's on the file system, because Windows will basically run this kind of caching service or some stuff that even the Microsoft engineers had problems explaining this, how it works. So actually there is really no user action needed. What we saw is that, for example, when you open the folder where the link file is located, it automatically sends the hash. Or if you move the mouse over the file, which is again totally illogical, but yeah, it's Windows, so you never know. And also just by moving the selection over it, it again sends the hash. So it's that simple, and you get the hash remotely. And as we said before, you can use after this if you crack it, like RDP or pass the hash or whatever is open on the attacked side.
Okay, so a little demo.
So basically what we want to show you in the demo is that we placed a server on the internet, and we have a Windows machine also facing the internet, and we will we want to show you that what happens when you create this link file and how it is behaving, and like you see that we receive the hash. So it's yeah quite simple, but we want to demo it. Hopefully all the connection works and everything is fine. Live demo.
So this is the forge LNK file. The file URL is placed in the target.
So So as you also saw, this kind of LNK file is basically the link file or shortcut that you also have on your desktop. So you have a hard time disabling this. So it's not like antivirus will catch it or the connections will be blocked or whatever. Because this is really standard stuff.
So here we have a reverse shell from the Windows. It's just to fake the user interaction. So I will open an Explorer to the place where the guys has unzipped the archive he received in the email. And I think we received it, but we missed it maybe. Oh, sorry, it was Explorer.
So meanwhile, we are typing the command. We can tell you a little about the experience with Microsoft, because we have this Microsoft support, because we have a lot of Windows servers and desktops and so on, and that's what we get for it. We contacted them that, hey, the links are going out. Yes, and you can see that at least four times it is received. So this is the attacker on the internet, basically, and that's how it looks like. So it really flies through the whole internet. In most of the cases.
So here we found the external IP. So if the 445 is not blocked over internet, you still receive the hash over internet, which is pretty dangerous.
Actually, in our setup, when we receive this kind of file from the customer we had or partner, we were lucky because we happened to ask the admins and so on to block like ports and stuff. So in our case, we were lucky because it was not sent out and the guys didn't break it. But we were thinking what would have happened in case they crack it. In the case of the crack, they would, for example, have access like webmail and external sources, and it's pretty dangerous to have a webmail access, because then after this you see all the email addresses of the whole company, you can read the emails and check out what's going on, what is being used by the company, and from that it's like a lot of information. So a lot of people think, hey, it's just webmail, but yeah, webmail is like a really, really good and powerful source for the further attacks. That's why also very often, like in case of APTs and advanced attacker, they use just spear phishing. And then after they got one infection, then they are really easy to go. And if, for example, in case they infected the person, only one account or webmail or whatever, they are inside and they just put an LNK file to the share. The share is mapped for all the users on the company. And then end of the game, they crack it. So in case in our resources, we only have like a smaller amount of machines that we can use for crack. But imagine some advanced attackers, they have like a hell of a lot of resources to crack NTLM hashes, even with a lot of, even with longer passwords. So we normally recommend at least 11 characters on Windows.
So that's it. The guys just opened the folder which is containing the .lnk or .url, and it will fetch automatically the resource with the hash. It's really, really fast, and it's working over internet under certain condition. And I think it's like the drop lnk again, but it's not patched, I think. I don't know if exactly drop lnk is patched everywhere, but last time I checked a few days ago, it was not working on this box.
Actually, there were this kind of LNK attacks before, similar ones, but more complicated exploits. several of them already fixed by Microsoft. And for some reasons, which we don't understand, the most simple one, which is that one, was never ever fixed. So Microsoft engineer or security engineer or whatever told me that, yeah, it's like hot potato in which you need like a VPAT, you need like SMB setting, and you need a lot of default things. For this, you do not need man in the middle, you do not need VPAT enabled, you actually need nothing. It's just working.
Yeah, so as a recap, what do we find cool about this is that it's a feature, it's working from XP to Windows 10, and Microsoft said to us they won't fix it. And it's similar to Drupal NK, but simpler. And we don't need no VPAD, no active attacks, so it's pretty silent and undetectable, I think.
Yeah, and actually there is a fix or some kind of change which you can make in Windows, which we won't tell you. So sorry for this, we are the red guys, not the blue guys. And we are testers, so we don't spoil it. But if you contact your Microsoft support, I think they will remember this case and most probably help you fixing it. And you will wonder that this fix, what does it have to do with this kind of NTLM leak? Because it's totally irrelevant. And if you are looking for this and trying to fix it, you find basically nothing on the internet which would be logical. So it's quite obscure stuff.
And why it's not really deadly is that remote exploitation over internet is sometimes difficult because of blocking of port 445. But we have had some presentation where the guys said maybe with IPv6 and T-Redo-Tunnel it's working because Windows will think the T-Redo-Tunnel is local and will send the hash over this tunnel. But it's still room for research. Sorry.
No problem. I wanted to actually mention one more thing, which is Microsoft recommended us to disable NTLM and use Kerberos and so on, and to make it really secure. So we tried it, and our Windows team made the changes recommended by Microsoft. And what actually happened in the end is that, well, the mailing exchange server stopped working. Okay, the VPN on Windows also stopped working. Then there is integration to AD from macOS X. It also stopped working, and a lot of other services. So we got a tip how to fix this, which we couldn't use because then we actually couldn't use most of the useful Windows services that are at least working.
And that's it. Thank you for listening and for your attention. If you have any question, then feel free.
Yes, thank you.